When we talk about the work of da'wah, we often talk about the clarity of the Qur'an and how perfect it is and how miraculous it is and how amazing it is. But that's only half the picture. The clarity of the message and the perfection of the message is one half the picture. What gave that message its credibility above and beyond its own perfection is the one that was delivering that message had a character that had credibility, had a personality that had credibility. He was really recognized as a symbol of justice and honesty and mercy in the society even before he uttered a word of Quran. He already established his credibility. Now think about that. How are we going to actually do the job of da'wah just by making pamphlets about how awesome the Quran is and not have any credibility of our own? We don't stand for justice. We're not the examples of taking care of the needy or standing up against all forms of injustice, whether they affect us or anybody else. We don't go in an uproar when somebody else is oppressed. Oh, that's their problem. But if something comes and happens to us, we're ready to protest. That's not justice. That's a self-centered attitude. And that makes us no different than any other lobby group that is interested only in helping who? Their own selves, not the cause of justice. But this is something the Messenger ﷺ was far above. And even, I mean, my teacher, when explaining this concept, gives some very powerful examples. Like, you know, the family of Yasir radiallahu anhu was being tortured, killed. What did the Messenger tell them? ﷺ. Is there a protest? No torturing Muslims. We're not terrorists. We're just asking for, you know, to believe in one God. And, you know, we're not here to hurt anyone. And he's not in, no protest. Actually, he tells them, be patient. He tells Yasir and his family to be patient, that their reward will be in paradise. But at the same time, when a mushrik comes to the Messenger ﷺ, and Abu Jahl has taken his money, and he comes to the Messenger, and this is a mushrik coming to the Messenger for help, at a time when the Muslims are being persecuted. And so he comes to him for help, and he says, Abu Jahl took my money. He grabs him by the hand, goes to Abu Jahl, and tells him, better give him his money back. He starts fighting for the rights of who? For the mushrik. When the Qur'an came down with ayat about the baby girl being buried, it wasn't the baby girls of Muslims. These were baby girls that were born in non-Muslim families, in mushrik families. You could say that's their problem. But no, the Qur'an came with a call of justice. Justice that was affecting Muslims or not affecting Muslims. Justice that happened, whether it dealt with us or not, the Qur'an came with this universal call, which also gave it credibility.
Download our mobile applications or register on our official website to get access to exclusive content. Links given in description of video.